What's up, nerds? Let me go fix that light for a second, and then we'll be right back. There we go. Yeah, we're in the process of reorganizing my studio space, so the result is that things are a little disorganized behind me. That's my printer. That's the tripod from where we shot the podcast last night. It's a whole thing. All right, let me just double check that everything is working as it should be. That we are appropriately live. Let me shove over a little bit here. There we go. Hi to everybody in the chat. Thanks to Rich for reminding me to turn my Steam off, my Steam Messenger. Because I'd be super embarrassed to get a message from him while I'm streaming. So I'm just getting all my windows coordinated. It's one of those weird things you never think about when you're streaming. You're like, I have like 5 windows open. And it's sort of weird to pick up which ones I need. I mean, obviously I need Skyrim, but I also need XSplit so I can monitor the stream. I need my spreadsheet so that I can see what the hell we're doing. Nobody cares. All right, cool. Huh. Things I just learned about Skyrim. If I hit my number key to change my view, it also changes my weapons. Weird. Okay, we're going to try and avoid that. So let's re-equip our greatsword here. And if we recall, this is Janet. So last week, I made tons of characters for this Multiplicity, and we're going to revisit them as we unlock them, which is something we sort of decided on last stream. We've got about 12, everybody from warlocks to 2 weapon fighters to a thunder god to an archer. But for now, all we got is Janet. Janet's the Dragonborn. Light armor, 2-handed swords, Super Saiyan hair, archer buddy. What's up, buddy? You can see her sick Dragonborn back tattoo. So, normally what one does is one goes and... let's check my inventory for a second. Cool. One goes and, you know, visits the Jarl of Whiterun and advances the main quest. And, you know, we fight the dragon Mermelmir. It's like a Robert Munsch novel. Sick Canadian literature references. Stick around for those. But we are not going to do that because, A, the mods I have make leveling a lot slower. And, B, he will kill us because of that. We have 100 health, 110 health, something like that. We don't do a whole lot of damage. We aren't very well armored. Oh, what's up, wolf? Get wrecked! That's right. I just said get wrecked on an internet stream. I'm that person now. So, there's a couple ways we can do this. We can go and, like, grind stuff and grind skills. But remember, only weapon skills level me. So that light armor point I just got, it improves my skill and lets me do things, but it doesn't... Oh, no, there's Thalmor. There's Thalmor. Guys. I really want to fight them, but I think that they'll just kick my ass. All right. Now for the art of the quick save. Oh, good, you can see that. What's up, Thalmor? Are there guards around? There's a guard, like, right over there. We'll just follow these folks. We're going the same way. So, yeah, we can grind out a bunch of levels. That's one way to do it. Another way to do it, and the way we are actually going to do it, I think, is we're going to go and get by with a little help for our friends. which means we need to make some more friends. So I am excited for that. Now these Thalmor punks, we just need to get, like, out of... I don't want to get in trouble with the Whiterun guards, but I really want to whack these motherfuckers. I despise the Thalmor. They are monsters. They are dicks. They are high elves that oppress the people of Skyrim and the Imperials alike. They are imperious and murderous and torturous, and rumor has it that they traffic in slaves. And so basically they can get effed. So, excuse me for a moment. Excuse me, sir. Sir.
You're interfering with official...
I'm sorry, madam. Never should have come here. All of these. Health is low. Let's grab a healing potion. I think we've got a couple of those. Yeah. How do you feel? Oh, and I'm dead. Yeah. Problem is, we're... one. Thank you. Yeah, Rich. Absolutely. 100% kill the Thalmor. Problem is, we're level one. And... oh, we do have a level up, though. Okay. So maybe we can do this. We're going to start with the wizard.
Move along.
Hack the wizard to pieces. Back up. Pick up the other wizard. And then the second we win, we get our level up. We are going to up our health, obviously, because we desperately, beginning of the game, we desperately need more health. We're also going to need magicka so that we can get into some higher level spells later, but right now, health is our bread and butter. So, our health refills. That's what's going to win this fight. But also, we've got two perks to spend, so let's see if there's anything we can get that's good. So we've got 12 and two-handed now, which gets me Skullcrusher. So... power attacks with warhammers can daze targets, which is super useful. We don't have a warhammer, though. But attacks with all my weapons ignore 50% of armor. And that is gonna... we're gonna get some serious mileage out of that. Light armor, we're at 13. The only thing we're really looking to get out of here is Nomad, which gives us faster speed on horses. Because you bet your ass we're gonna get some horses. Once we get into shields, we can get some block. Which gets us some improved stamina regen. You're a man with many problems, that's true. Oh! Bye-bye, Thumb... Fiendall! Buddy! Excuse me.
There's no escape! Not impressed.
Really? Is this what we're doing now, friend? Okay. Alright, Fandol, are you gonna chill out? Just heal up. Are you chill? Friend.
Divine smile on you, friend.
Are we cool? Oh, we're not cool. I did not realize that Fandol would just flip out on me. Okay. We're going to reload, because I like Fandol. He's my favorite archer buddy, and there's only, like, three archers in this whole game. I recommend that you both play Human Revolution and still be tempted to buy Mankind Divided, because Mankind Divided looks pretty good. So, here's what we're going to do. What have we got in our inventory right now? We have an iron dagger and some woodcutter's axes. So. Problem is, Fandol's going to fight me. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to free this prisoner and share some items. Buddy, I wish you... do I have any... no, I have no other armor to give him. All right. Here's a woodcutter's axe. Go get him, friend. Same plan. All right. Just a car down. I super hate the Thalmor. Like, I will go to extra lengths to kill them. So we're gonna get that level up. And again, we're gonna take the health increase. We're gonna grab the armor. Welcome to Skyrim, where we say scum, because we are scum. Boom! Spindle? Friend. Oh man, sorry. Sorry about your luck there. Thanks for the woodcutter's axe. We are an Imperial. All of our characters are Imperials because we can't change our race. You can, but it messes up your skill something bad. And I just got some books. So we've got Electric Charge, which is an advanced lightning spell. Forgotten Magic, I upped the drop rates on the books, which you can do in the settings for the mod, because A, the spells are really fun. These are spells that level up on their own, and they all have sort of a discipline and a theme. So for people like our Thunder God, our Warlock, our Fortress, these are going to be their like bread and butter. Bretons are the best race, like statistically. My problem with Bretons is that they make the game too easy. Like, we're going to be doing this stream for a while, and the game gets way easier if you're a Breton, because you've got 50% magic resist. You just take less damage from everything that matters, except people with big hammers. So yeah, we're going to learn these three spells, but spoilers, we ain't going to be able to cast them for a while. Seed of Life is 212 mana. Void Bolt is 326. Until we start, like, getting some bottom-tier destruction spells, we're not getting anywhere on this stuff. So, we'll get there when we get there. But in the meantime, at least we know them. I will point out that the unlock for the Thunder God is lightning spells. Let's say lightning spells that we can cast, but and rain. So we're getting close to there. Oh, that's a giant. We're gonna go around him. I don't like fighting giants. They do a lot of damage. They're a real pain in the ass. Also, they just don't drop a lot of good loot. Yeah, no, Bretons get a ton of magic resist, plus all the ways you can add do it in the game, which is plenty. And we'll definitely get there, but at the beginning of the game, like the first half of the game, it just makes it so easy, and there's no risk. Like here, my only real risk is like breaking up with Feindahl, which I don't want to do because he's lovely and wonderful, and I would never want to betray him. So where are we going? I wasn't just following those Thalmor for my health. So rule number 705. We walk everywhere first. It's just fun. You get to see the surroundings. You get to have chance encounters and things like that. So where I am going is Markarth. The City of the Reach. And I'm going there to get the Drunken Knight, who is going to become one of our best friends. Especially in the early game. Feindahl? Ooh, buddy. Bye-bye. Actually, let's... Hunters. Could steal a horse and ride, but walking is fun. We're gonna harvest this Skeever. So Hunterborn is the mod that gives me all these, extra menus, and they're super neat. Right now, what I'm in it for is those small animal bones. I don't even want the meat. Because those small animal bones are going to let me use Hunterborn's crafting system, which is Scrimshaw, to craft some jewelry once I level up my skinning a bit more.
Oh.
And some of that jewelry is magic, and some of it, it's all kind of minor, but it can be a pretty good advantage, especially at the very beginning of the game. What's up? What are you up to?
I'm on my way to Windhelm to join up with the Stormcloaks.
I don't know about
Ulfric
that.
Has the right of it.
We are not joining the Stormcloak. Excuse me? Hello? You're a bandit! You have a sword! Can I have your sword? I guess I can. Earthbound weapon, that's a good one. That's some good stuff. Now we are strictly light armor. So that's how we're rolling right now. So all of that cool ass heavy Imperial armor, but we can equip this Elven armor. Just need to find out why my headgear mod isn't working. But I'm gonna do that later tonight. So for now we're just gonna take off my helmet. There, now we look like a badass. Fiendal, you too, buddy, will wear Elven armor, because I have a surplus. I'll even give you the helmet. Look at how cool you are! Look at how cool you are! What's your sword? You have an Imperial sword right now. That seems fine. Alright, look at us. We match squad goals. I'm gonna admit, I kind of want to kill that guy because he's just gonna grow up and become a Stormcloak. But I'll let him grow up and become a Stormcloak and then I'll kill him then. Look at this leather armor. I don't usually go for Elven armor, but you got what you got. Armor ratings are what you got. That person also looks like an Imperial, judging from their cape. But it's hard to tell. Oh no, they're a guard. So the roads are a lot more crowded in mine because I've got merchant patrols and... Oh, your Stormcloak. How does Fiendal feel about fighting Stormcloak? Because this might be a deal breaker for us. I don't remember. Seems fine with it. Good. Yoink. Stormcloaks, get fucked. No, Stormcloaks are a horrible ideology. They serve a terrible master, and they do so, frankly, at their own risk. Alright, slice and dice this wolf. See if we can't get some more skinning out of it. Later we're gonna get, like, hunting knives and things like that, but for right now, we're literally just foraging for whatever we've got. Like, this stuff's gonna turn into garbage. Ooh, improving. Canine tooth, wolf claws, large animal bones. We don't want the meat. I've got some food, and we do need to eat. Realistic needs and diseases says we need to eat and drink. Reminds me, let's check how we're doing on that. We are hungry and thirsty. So if we look in my effects, I take penalties. Health and stamina regen is 30% down. Magic and stamina regen is 30% down. So, gotta get some food and some drink in us. So let's go eat some charred meat, which is just the worst stuff you can get. And eat some green apples, which make you both full, but also not thirsty. Let's grab our buff spell. Do we have enough? Yeah, we can cast that too. Let's put that under 5. Yeah, now we've got a bit of a buff. Earthbound, I forget what it does at the most basic level. So it increases our magic or regeneration. But it's also going to gain levels. And it's going to bump our alteration skill, which is a really good skill for, like, defensive spells and all. You caught your foot in a bear trap. What happened here? A dead guy, a dead Khajiit. The book. Some clothes. There's a trap. But there's no ambush. Okay, well, we'll keep going. It's probably nothing. We can't really do anything for them. They didn't leave a note. Because the game thinks I should join the Stormcloak Rebellion. Spoilers game, you are wrong. Dog? Hello, dog. Your dog! Are you upset? No, you're super chill, actually. You just killed that dog, dude! I don't even like dogs, I'm gonna kill you. I mean, I'm also gonna kill you because you're a Thalmor, but... just killed that dog for like no reason. It could have been bros. God, Thalmor. This is why we don't like the Thalmor. What do? He just killed a dog. We're not even gonna dress that dog. We are gonna dress these skeeters though. Gotta get that alchemy supplies. Alright. Field dress. Thanks, Vandal. Just walk right up on my ass. Really appreciate it. Just give it a pelt. Yeah, so we're going to gain levels in this and be able to turn it into slightly more useful things. And are we in a position to scrimshaw anything? Yeah. So I get some leather strips, which I have some back at the house. I can start building some necklaces and the next level, I think, is rings. And they're minor magic items, but they can be really useful, especially for hunting. One of them gives me night vision. One of them makes my sort of foraging and my skinning more valuable, or yield more results, I guess is the operative term. Walking to Markarth. Yeah, we're only going to walk the first time. We might ride for a bit. One of the other advantages of Skyrim, auto run. Just sit back and enjoy the ride. What's up, Wolf? Oh, you're dead now. Leveling that two-handed skill. No, we'll stay on the road. I forget which way we're supposed to go, actually. Yep, we're fine. Keep seeing all this stuff that's available to explore these caves on the map and whatnot, and I know what some of them are, but I haven't been to nearly all of them. Yeah, Rich, you mentioned the chat stealing a horse. I don't actually steal anything in Skyrim. Basically, ever. Even with thieves, like, I only steal stuff as, like, part of missions. Again, I find it makes the game too easy if you just, like, kill people and take their stuff, or, well, I mean, people who aren't trying to kill you. But it's also just not the kind of character that I want to have. What's up, people? What are you up to? Hello? You have a bodyguard.
I have nothing to say to you. Now move along, or I'll
order
my guard to attack.
Understood. Alright, see you later. Goodbye forever. No. Like, that's the thing, we're not just gonna fight people because they're rude. We're gonna fight people because they fight me. All in all, we are heroes. Look at that sky. Look at that sky. I did get some high-res sky mods. Because it makes me happy to sometimes just, like, look at that sky. Like, this game is so pretty. It's funny, because I like this game came out years ago, and I've got all the like 4K resolution mods and things like that. Not taking the guy's horse. I mean, we don't kill people for being dicks. If we killed people for being dicks, Rich, you'd be dead like 10 times over. What's up, buddy? Stormcloak soldier. Okay, exception to every rule. Ooh! Sorry about your luck there, son. Say goodbye to your sword. Findal, you should carry some stuff for me. I'm going to keep this steel mace because we've got plans for it. Not going to need that Stormcloak hide... or cloak. Yeah, Stormcloaks have cloaks. That's weird. Alright. Scaled helmet. Steel shield. All the times I killed you in Minecraft. People can go watch the Minecraft videos on the channel. I only killed you like, I don't know, 5 times. Ooh, now we're floating. That's bad. Drink from the river. Normally I wouldn't do that because you can get diseases, and diseases are awful. But there's a shrine right here, so we can cure any diseases that we might have. You get a little tiny shrine benefit too. Yeah, I have all the 4K resolution mods and things like that, but I look around at this game, and I'm like, I understand that there are games that look way better than this. I have a bunch of them. I've been playing Far Cry 4, and, you know, like, but just can't get over how pretty this game is. Like, it's just, I don't know, it's not hyper-realistic pretty, I guess. It's like nostalgia pretty. Like, it isn't even that it's like the prettiest game. It just makes me happy. Also, I think we might be lost. No, we are still on the road to where we're going. Kind of. Yeah, we're good. I mean, we're covered in blood and we look like an extra from Dragon Age, but whatever. Because, yeah, there's something very hawk about this, like, look. Alright. Boot this cart because it has no gravity. And keep moving. Yeah, I can't run forever, which is sad. But once we get some cash, we'll get some horses. How are we doing on cash? 260 bucks. Not a lot. I'm going to try to do a bounty or two today. And horses will speed up life a whole lot. But then we'll ride from place to place. And we're not going to steal horses because we don't steal horses. Are you seriously another Stormcloak soldier? Sir? Don't do that. Listen, just stay right there. Just stand very still. I need to perform a science experiment on you.
I cannot best you.
No, that's right, you can't. Excuse me, sir. Please. Thank you. Thank you for your battle axe. Stormcloak soldiers are kill on sight. Right up until I encounter a big battle and it crashes the whole game. Which I think I eliminated? I'm not 100% on. What's up here? What are you folks doing? That's an Imperial cloak, so you're probably good to go. Your Imperial's escorting a prisoner. Well, this guy's probably fine. You're probably going to chop his head off. That's pretty much what Imperials do to people, is my understanding. So, carry on. I feel like Janet being the Dragonborn, has no particular alliance or feelings toward the Imperials, She just really hates the Stormcloaks. I mean, we've definitely got characters who are allied with the Imperials, but we haven't found them yet. So, let's discover some things. Don't get any XP for because that's not how the game works, but it does make them put them on my map, and I like things that are on my map. You can buy a dog in Markarth too. I forget his name. I think it's like Justice or something. Vigilance. That's his name. He's out here at the stable. The only problem with the animal NPCs is that I don't really like them. And also, like in the sense that they can't do as much as the PCs. I don't get to play dress up with them or anything like that. But also, like the dogs in particular, until you get the huskies that are in Dawnguard, I don't really like the meshes. Like, I don't enjoy it. So, we're not gonna bother. We might find if we find like a stray dog or something, then we'll definitely adopt it and we'll like give it a home. But we're not gonna roll heavy in dogs, at least until Dawnguard. Ah, Markarth, city of safety, city of comfort, city of... Oh, God. It's weird to think that this is a place where, like, anybody who reads a book gets magic powers. Like, everyone has magicka. Of course we're looting this guy. We're player characters.
Stay back. The Markarth city guard have this all under control. There are no force here.
Gods. Are you alright? Did you see what happened?
Who are you and where did you... Yes. I was right there. He almost killed me.
I'm so sorry.
Sure. He almost killed me. I mean, in the deepest sense of... You know, oh. Maybe he never actually killed me. So Eltris just gave me a note that'll lead me to the sort of center of corruption. It's this just sort of starting quest of Markarth. A city of silver and blood and all kind of stuff. We're not actually going to spend that much time here. We're going to read Dance of Fire, though. Speech increased to 1. Ooh. But, partly because that quest winds you up in prison, and I currently, in my current state, would not survive prison.
Come on in. The Silverblood Inn has plenty of strong drink and
clean. We're going to talk to...
Drinks here are watered down, but they're cheap.
Need something?
You. This guy.
You a fighting gal? Got any ale?
I'm not gonna fight you. I'm going to give you a beer.
I think I'm going to get another drink. My favorite drink.
Follow me.
Not waste any time.
One of the advantages of the expanded follower framework is I can have more than one follower. I can have, I think, up to 100. I don't recommend doing that because it's awful. I think I had 10 one time. It was really fun until I went inside. At which point it got completely ridiculous and terrible. I do recommend there's a mod that you can get if you want to have more than one follower. Like having 3 or 4 is actually kind of fun. Again, partly from the dress up aspect. There's a mod that I got that's just called Get Out of the Way. And what it is, I'll post the mod list hopefully tomorrow. But and what it does is it just makes your followers get out of the way when you like run into them, so they'll shift backward.
Be careful.
And the result is that it makes it life a lot easier to navigate inside buildings when you have a bunch of followers. I do not have Warzones installed. I don't really want to stream with Warzones because it's super unstable.
How can I help you?
And it can crash your game. And I really don't like streaming things that are going to crash my game a whole lot. Also, Warzones makes the early game super deadly. Warzones is a mod that adds shocking new Warzones. Like, you know, areas with tons and tons of battles and fall and between dozens of people. and it interacts strangely with some mods, some of which I have. I've had good and bad experiences with it before. But also, it's just like, if you wander into a war zone before, like, level 10, you're just dead. They did release an improved version, and I tested it out for a bit, but it was mostly just not the experience I was looking for. Now we have Koznick, who is the drunken knight. Koznick is a brat. He drinks, as he will continually tell you forever. He has a bunch of armor. His skills lie in two-handed weapons, actually, and light armor. I always thought he was heavy and one-handed and block. Well, you just got significantly less useless. You basically have the same skill set as Janet. Spoilers, that's not a great plan for you, buddy. But right now, you're going to wear heavy armor, and you're going to use a one-hander. Maybe we'll pass you a battle axe or something. He's a Breton, so he's got 25% magic resist, which makes him a little more survivable. You know any spells? Oh, this is just for teaching you spells. Okay. Alright. So, with that in mind, let's take this steel mace and steel shield. I think it just assumed he was good at one-handers because he has a one-hander. Well, now you got a battle axe, buddy, but you're still staying in that heavy armor. Spain Doll gets the light armor. So, 7:30, we have two followers. Laughing. Now we need to go pick up somebody else. Again, if we're going to do some bounties, if we're going to fight a dragon, we need a bit of an edge. Like early game, let me tell you, early game is tough. And that's the idea. So, we're going to take these two dudes and we're going to head over to Riften. And in Riften, you bet your ass we're going to walk. Part of the reason we're going to walk is because, A, it's fun. And B, we're going to have experiences along the way that are going to raise some of our skills. So Riften's like in like the opposite corner. City of Thieves, city of all kinds of stuff. So we're going to literally walk basically diagonally across the entire map of Skyrim in the next... My sword doesn't really have an edge. It's just this like big solid object that I hit people with. In the next, like, hour. And we're going to try and pick up a mage there who's a mercenary. We need money in order to hire him. And also in order to buy a horse to speed this, all this bullshit up. What's up, goat? That was mean. I shouldn't have done that. Sorry. Our needs.
Don't care. Leave me alone.
I don't have time for this.
What are you guys doing?
Now come along quietly, and we won't have to get rough.
Seems not okay.
Mother, I think she's telling the truth.
I'm not going anywhere. Now back off before I do something drastic.
Yeah, stop harassing this woman.
She doesn't have the scar.
What? Oh, you're right.
We've made a mistake. Now move along before that mouth.
Move along before that mouth of yours gets in trouble.
What pester someone? Make sure it's the right
hell's your deal?
Yes.
We're looking for information about a woman. We believe she may be hiding in Whiterun, but we're checking everywhere to be sure.
Christ's sake, guys.
Foreigners. What a nuisance.
I love that the Red Guard woman is like foreigners. It's like she's like, yeah, I'm Red Guard by ethnicity, but not necessarily by birth. I mean, spoilers, there are black people living in Skyrim. There aren't, but there are definitely lots of Red Guard who are native to Skyrim. Because their families came here long ago, and they have lived here all their lives. Oh, what's up, more Thalmor?
interfering with official Thalmor business.
Am I? Are you gonna fight me? Are you gonna fight me? Who are you? What are you doing? What are you doing? No, I'm not. I'm not walking away. I'm.
Walk away now.
Nope. I'm in your face. I'm in your face. What are you gonna do?
This doesn't concern you. Watch it.
Aww.
You're interfering with official Thalmor business. This doesn't concern you.
I'm gonna save this
citizen.
For a second. Just, I can't remember. All right, Thalmor, buddy. You did. Faindal, are we cool? Yeah, we're cool. What a fickle dude. Alright. Cosnic. Now, we know that you're better at light armor, because we learned that, because we looked at your stats. So, give us that Imperial stuff back. And take that stuff. Look at you now. It's like we have a uniform. It's like we're just wearing a big sign that says, I killed a bunch of Thalmor earlier. They're dead now. I'm a happier person because of it. Alright. I did say today would be mostly walking. There is going to be a bunch of that. But yeah, I love the encounters you have on the road. I love looking up and sort of enjoying the game. That was one of the things I found with fast travel. And I still have fast travel turned on. We're going to definitely do some of that. But for the first while, I always find that fast travel sort of... I pay more attention to quest objectives than I do to the game, to the atmosphere. And I want to be a part of this world. And part of that means maybe slowing down a bit and taking a look around. Like, looking at waterfalls. Understanding sort of how this region is shaped. It's all mountains. And the Reach is, I think it was the first episode we read The Legend of Red Eagle. And the Reach is where Red Eagle was from. He's their King Arthur figure. Hello, who are you?
I've been hunting and fishing in these... It's not
you're
like
a hunter.
I'm coaching it. Can I go look?
Can you buy anything from me? No, I really don't have much that you want. Okay.
Until
cool.
Next time.
Later. Oh, yeah, I find it sort of relaxing. And it's also dark, but... And as Janet, we don't have any ranged attacks until we get, He's just fighting mud crabs. Are you having fun? You think this is a game? You think you just get to sit around and fight mud crabs? We're gonna fight dragons, son. No, I enjoy the walking around bit. It lets me sort of... be part of this world and imagine it. And I just heard a bunch of wolves. Oh, they're there. Yeah, we don't have any ranged attacks. Oh. Just get a look at a wolf's crotch there. Cosmic, finish that. Fine, I'll finish it. God, why do I pay you? Gave you the shiny. I gave you a beer, I gave you a shiny uniform, I gave you a new axe, and now I'm allowing you to risk your life for me. So, Janet needs your service. She's level 2. That looks like a giant cave. We don't want to go in there. That's some bad news bears is what that is. Misty mountains and vistas, and I will admit the vistas get old sometimes. There is a point where you're just like, nope, fast traveling, and we'll definitely get there. But, you know, just want to sort of take it all in. Also, if we find some people on the road, we might get to make a bit more money, which is good because we're gonna need $500 to hire Mercurio, and right now we don't even have to pay him. Not to mention that if we want to buy a horse, it's going to be like $1,500. Don't mind us. We're just passing through your little valley. That's a tower that's probably full of bandits. One of the other things I try and do is I try not to go to bandits or giant caves or giant camps or dragon summits until I have a bounty quest for it. Oh, no, that's not bandits. That's probably Forsworn, the Rebels of the Reach. But, and the reason for that is just... it's easy... In a game like this, it's really easy to know where everything is. Like it's... There's procedurally generated stuff, but... Oh, God. There's, like, four... Yeah, see, this is where we get into bandits. What's up, buddy? Oh, you're dead. Oh, we move now. Go. Okay. And this is why we have friends. Is it two bandit chiefs? Okay, well, that guy's dead. Oh, God. He just clocked me. We're gonna pop some potions here. Potion of strength ain't gonna do much. No, I don't think I want you to hit me. That sword is very large. I'm probably gonna steal it when I kill you, and best believe I am gonna kill you. Oh, two-handed just leveled up. That's good. We're going to need it to take this hit. So we're going to increase our health again to 130 or 140. And do we have anything else we can get? So we can get the axe talent with a little more. Really what we're going for here, if we can get up to 30, is faster attacks. Is there anything else we can get? Not right now. Again, like, all of our skills start super low. So, two-handed is pretty much it. We're gonna hold down my... I'll spawn the block. We're gonna block. Oh. But we filled up our Magicka. Oh, you're getting Sovngarde, you sumbitch. Trust me when I tell you, they are waiting for you. Your sword is slower than mine, and that is why I win. So yeah, you can see that... What? There's another bandit? What's up, buddy? Excuse me. Oh, Fendel just puts him down. Damn. Well done. Alright. So let's see what we got here. Bandit chiefs have a ton of health, and in the early game they are super dangerous. Bone mold armor. I'm encumbered now, but there's the brakes. But yeah, my guys, they can get put down and they can get basically put out of the fight unless I can find a way to heal them. I can give them potions so they can heal themselves, but I don't usually because it's no fun. Iron giant sword. Let's see if that's better than my current sword. It's also a lot slower. It's 10 damage better. Bye-bye, Steel Greatsword. We'll give you two, we'll give you to Cosmic here. So, Cosmic, give me your Battle Axe. take this greatsword. And then Feindel, because you're my courier. Take everything I don't want. And we're just gonna deal with it all later, probably after the show or on a bonus stream, when we get around to actually dealing with all the stuff that I pick up. We'll see. Alright. Yeah, now we have a ludicrously large anime sword. And it's really slow, but it does a lot of damage. Look at this thing. Like, and appreciate that Janet is tall. Like, she is not short. And this thing is too big for her. This is exactly Janet's kind of sword. Here's the cart with the bear traps again. Oh, there's a dead horse down here. Yeah, somebody took out this guy's horse. And left a trap for him. Maybe it was those bandits. Well, they're dead now. Justice has been served. Yeah, so I have a mod called Obis, Organized Bandits in Skyrim. And one of the things it does, most of what it does, is it adds about 300 new kinds of bandits. So rather than just like bandits, bandit mages, bandit archers, and bandit chiefs, you get like reavers and betrayers and puppet masters and all kinds of things. Like, they have all kinds of different powers and move sets and abilities, and it makes the game so much more diverse and so much more fun. There's none of this, you know, fight the same five guys over and over again. That is the thing that gets super boring for me. It's like here, I have to innovate strategy. Who's this guy? Stormcloak Soldier. Oh, yeah, you had a terrible accident. It was a tragedy. Everybody was deeply sad. We cried. Said some kind words. I believe it was blah blah, this person's a Stormcloak, they made poor life decisions, now they're dead. Fox, are you mad? Because you sound a bit mad. Gotta throw our bot on again. Revelers! What's up, buddy?
It's good to see another merry soul.
I don't seem that merry. There's a bunch of giants over there. You should party with them.
Share a bottle of hunting brew.
Sure.
Cheers, my friend. May your adventures find you brave and horse.
Alright, so my earthbound weapon just leveled up. So let's go to my mods. As we remember, I have a lot. And we'll go to Forgotten Magic. And earthbound weapons under Druid. So each set of spells has sort of an archetype. And now is where I can essentially spend talent points to level up my spells. So I can increase my stamina regen, increase the duration of the spell, spell damage, healing, health, which is maybe what we want. I can get some damage effects. I think we're gonna go for health for right now. So, and there's a max level on this. I think I set it to 8. And so now it'll increase my health a little bit, which makes it actually useful as a buff spell. Like, it's increasing my magic or regen and my health, which will help me significantly with my survivability. And that will happen the next time I cast it, which is right now. So it takes most of my magic, and it only lasts me for about... 2 minutes? Yeah, like you can see the duration ticking away in the top corner. But if I can level it up a bit more, then I can increase the duration. If I can level up my skill, then I can increase the duration as well. So I can get it to the point where it lasts pretty long. Who's this person and what are they up to? What's their jam? I think I know. Hello.
This one has something sweet for the fellow trapper.
What are you talking about?
The finest skooma.
Skooma!
The sweetest moon sugar. At a fair price.
Oh, man. Skooma. Skooma is the drug of choice in Tamriel, really, like the whole world. I first discovered it in Morrowind because that was the first Elder Scrolls game I played, but they make Edoin elsewhere, and they make it from Moonsugar, and it makes you sort of fatigued and high, and it's like it's supposed to be terrifyingly addictive, and you know what? I'll intimidate you.
That's not going to happen.
Are you gonna fight me? Oh, you are gonna fight me. Well, Jesus! Where did you go? We're here. Oh, I'll take your money and your blue sugar and your skooma, and I'll see if I can fence it to somebody. Or maybe we'll have another character who can fence it to somebody. And these Khajiits are merchants, if I'm not mistaken. And they are legit. And on the up and up.
It is us.
Yeah, Lejon, Kayla, and
the white flakes that sometimes fall from the sky.
Yeah, that's a fortress full of bandits. We're not going in there. It's dangerous as hell. This, I believe, is Mike the Liar, who is a traditional Elder Scrolls. Oh, it's Lacoon the Sage, actually. So this guy sells some of those forgotten magic spells that we've been sort of finding and leveling up. Which reminds me, did we find any more? No. What do we got up here? Looks like Imperials. Yeah, they get to stay. And what time is it? It's 4 a.m.
Legion's always looking for strong, capable warriors.
Stay sharp. So we have the Join the Imperial Legion quest, and we killed a Stormcloak. Which means we've unlocked Henry, our war archer that we made. So he might make an appearance in next week's stream. So today I've got a sort of a specific plan, and we're going to focus on Janet. Also because switching specialties in like the beginning of the game is not super advisable. You can get by, but it's not a lot of fun either. Believe me when I tell you I got special plans for this wagon. We're probably not on the Tuesday night stream, so maybe on a bonus stream. Dude, you should totally play Deus Ex. I recommend the Adam Jensen serial killer run that I did. I don't know. Sometimes in some games, there's this thing that, like, there's this moment that, like, breaks me, and I'm just like, nope. I kill everyone I meet from here on out. Skyrim, happily, not so much. Ooh, fighting up ahead. Let's go see what's going on there. Let's pull out this sword. Somebody's hostile. Somebody was hostile. Good work, soldiers. Oh, they got a bunch of poison. So much cool stuff. Good work, soldiers of Whiterun. Glad that you could do that. I'm gonna be walking. We came from this way when we escaped the prison in episode 1. But now we're going back. We got a giant ass sword. We got armor. We got 2 companions in magic armor. Ooh, and we are very cold. This is actually going to become a problem if we're not careful. Oh, the pacifist and the ghost achievements in Deus Ex Human Revolution were so hard. I missed pacifist by like a tiny bit. Hey man, what's up?
Need something? Yes?
Hello.
I'm collecting ingredients to bring to the gourmet. You have heard of the... You know, I've heard the gourmet is...
Oh yeah, we talked to you before, didn't we? Okay. We have a problem, and I'm not entirely sure how we're going to solve it. problem is we're getting cold. If we get cold enough, we're gonna die. I think we might have to... So one way to do it is we can scavenge some firewood. And that will let us build a fire. And we can spend the night and like warm up. And we can also get indoors. That fire there, that's a giant fire. We ain't going there. So the cold is already penalizing our regeneration and things like that. Another level on Earthbound. I might need to turn the XP on that down a bit, but so let's go with the duration. So let's just make it last longer. Because right now we've got 175 health, which is considerably more. Yeah, unless we're also taking penalties to our skills. So one other option is we can get into... There's a Stormcloak camp up here. We'd have to basically kill everybody in it on account of that's our philosophy. And I don't know that we're equipped to do that. The third option is Valheim Towers, which is just up here. And it's full of bandits. And that's also dangerous. The only other place we know about is the abandoned prison. And I don't know if we're gonna make it that far. We're getting pretty cold pretty fast. So we might need to see if we can stand by their fire. Or try and make it... And they're already mad at us because we killed one of their friends. Let's go stand by their fire and see what happens. Don't think I don't see you! Ha 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 ha! See that little shimmer? Bandit Hiddens come at you when they're invisible. Yeah, we're warming up out here. And if they want to come out and fight me, they can do that. Looks like we got one coming up soon. What's up? Goodbye. Goodbye forever. Okay, what's our... Current exposure is minus 45. We're not wet. Which is good. That'll ramp up our exposure a lot. So why don't we keep moving? Let's see if we can either make it to the prison or find somewhere else with a fire. Normally I try and travel with firewood. And if I'd thought about it, I would have stopped at the house. Because the other thing is we have a woodcutter's axe. So if we can get to like a mill or anywhere that we can chop wood, we're going to be good. Because we can chop some wood and make a fire. Also, the rift tends to be a bit warmer. Because it's this little, like, valley. There's a giant camp up there. If we go there and try and warm ourselves at their fire, they would kill us. That's not going to be super fun. Keep trying to pick these flowers, forgetting that I already picked them on the way up back in like episode 1 when we busted out of the prison. Let's try and find shelter and try not to die. And we need to get some. So one of the things we need to do is build some camping gear. I can't just cut open a goat and hide in it. As much as, you know, that is a conceivable thing. I'm also a little big. A little chilly. Where are we? So, let's look at the rift. So we've still gotta come If we come up this way, we could go to Iverstead, which is right around here. That's probably would have been our best bet. So maybe we want to turn around a bit. But I don't remember exactly the way to get there either. Because that road goes through the mountains. It's awful. Let's just keep going. Don't look back. Let's check this road sign up ahead and ask for directions. Hey, look, there's a road to Iverstead. Iverstead's got an inn, among other things. It's a weird place. I like that every town in Skyrim is a little weird. Do I have a portable campfire? The answer is no. Not yet. Did you just kill a goat? You're dead now. I'm digging this giant sword. This is literally what it's called. It's called a giant sword. Let's keep going down the road to Iverstead. Yeah. We're not gonna, like, do a bandit fort, but knocking out stray bandits, no, I got no problems. But no, I can get portable campfires and camping kits and things like that. I just don't have any of them. Because I didn't make it a priority, and the result is that we are going to pay the price. I also know that over about here-ish, there's a mill. So we could, if we can make it there, we're pretty good. Blackthorn is, oh man, Blackthorn takes some explaining, but if we make it to Blackthorn, it'll be good too. Blackthorn is essentially a town that you build. Wolfcrotch kill shot. Bump my two-handers to 18. I always feel like a cheater with two-handers. It's probably one of my least favorite fighting styles. Just because it's a little less dynamic. But especially in the early game, it's just so much damage. That's hard to go wrong. What's over there? Oh, that'll do us. That'll do us. That's, can't think of the name. But it's friendly. It's a friendly settlement. Despite the fact that I think that there's Starkwater Crossing, yes. So we can head in here and warm up at their fire.
I tried.
What's up, everybody?
Coaxing the ore from the rock.
7 months or
what?
Oh,
oh God, she's gonna die.
I have. I'm sorry. My name is Iris the Elf. I was once one of. What? So
oh
she
my.
Was Iris the Younger, and I was Iris
I
the Elf.
I keep hearing stories about
and the
morally.
Name stuck with
sounds
me
like
ever
a
since.
Place.
All right.
That's the dark elf that's beside me. This guy here, Sondus Drenum.
I hear there's baked slaughter fish tonight.
Hey, Morrowind, of course, is where dark elves are from.
Here in Skyrim. Be careful.
And if I recall correctly, the Drenums are actually a super big family in Morrowind. So the notion that he thinks Morrowind is horrible is kind of funny. Alright, so that red bar on the side, that's us.
Yes,
that's our warmth filling up. So we're doing pretty well. Improved fast travel means we've got a cart here. And if we see her, which I don't currently, but let's see if her, no, her house is locked. So, Annika Cragjumper is here. She is one of the few other archers in Skyrim. There's only about, I think, 4 or 5 characters that you can get as companions who are straightforward. Like, every companion has something that they're good at. Some people are great wizards, some people are incredible fighters. You know, Feyndall is an archer, but he can also use a sword. But shockingly, for a game that's full of big, giant, burly Viking dudes, most of your companions are big, giant, burly Viking dudes. They are good at picking up heavy things and hitting things with them. So archers are few and far between. And we have one, but we can always use more. They're super fun. We've got to do a quest order, but we're not going to do that. We're going to keep moving. Through dangerous and treacherous mountain passes. Full of goats. So many goats. The rift is lousy with goats and spiders. But happily, you'll notice we haven't encountered any Thalmor, which makes this a much nicer place to hang out. Oh, yeah, these. One of the things I did when I first started installing mods was I found a mod that made the ore veins glow. The Drenims are also a family in, sorry, there's a message in the chat. It says Morrowind has a Duke Vedum Dren. Yeah, Orvis and Vedum Dren are a big deal in Morrowind. Rift in. Here's the switchback. But there's also a Drenim family. Which I'm sure will be in the wiki somewhere. Yeah, Orvis and Vedum Dren, I believe you need to deal with in order to finish the main quest. Now I completely lost my train of thought. As I am wont to do. More wolves. But yeah, no Thalmor. Much nicer roads. It gets more dangerous when you get higher level, probably because there's more spiders and there's dragons. The rift is lousy with dragons, and that makes life. It's Drenim with a Drenim. I might be misremembering. It's been 10, conservatively 10 years since I played Morrowind, but I clocked 1,000 hours in that game. It was so good. It was my first game like this. And I didn't play it like I play Skyrim, because I didn't know how to play it like I play Skyrim. Oh, the glowing ore veins. That's what it was. But I played that game so much. So I installed glowing ore veins. It's just a mesh replacement, so it doesn't even really take up one of your mod slots. Just because it makes my... it makes seeing them a lot easier. Like I mentioned, I'm super colorblind. So anything that makes spotting ore veins more straightforward, because Skyrim doesn't really have a colorblind mode, is something I'm super interested in. So it looks like I have no idea where we are. Alright, we're going to stay on this road. Yeah, the Drenims are part of House Telvanni. That's what it was. Ostavani's the, hey man, are you okay?
They got... Please help. I can... Ooh. Bandits attacked and ransacked my cart.
Yeah!
My camp is nearby in the ruins of Nilheim. Get me there safely, and you'll be rewarded.
The ruins? I sense a betrayal. Yeah, no, the Drenims are part of House Ostavani. There's a Drenim in, Or no, there's a Telvanni at the Wizard College. Berlin and Marriott, I think. And Morrowind has three houses. The Flalu, who are the merchants. The Redoran, who are the warriors.
Wait here. I'll be right back with your reward.
There's people here. What's up, buddy?
Look, you picked a bad time to get lost,
friend. Aww. Curse your sudden but inevitable betrayal. How you guys doing?
You're important.
Bye. Oh man, all I see is him just executing somebody. There's our freeze frame right there. So we're almost at 500 bucks, which is good. Oh, we're still picking up red. Somebody's here and they're mad. I'll take that coin purse. I'll take that stuff. I'll search this chest. Ooh, Amulet of Julianos. I don't remember which one that is. Julianos is god of magic? Question mark? The things I remember about this game and the things that I don't remember are weirdly... Alright, so we got another Warlock spell. That's good. That'll help us unlock our Warlock. Let's go inside here. There I am! Eh, that's really heavy and not worth a lot of money. Here I am. Hello. Hello, friend. Bye, friend. Bye forever. So yeah, we can activate this campfire. We had some firewood, because it's going to take, I think 6 firewood or something like that. We can get some soul gems. We can drink some skooma. That, on the other hand, that's some cash right there. God, I killed her so hard I got blood on the upper floor. Wolf Queen. Oh, this is all about Patima the Wolf Queen. So we're going to find out about Patima when we go to Solitude. She was Queen of Solitude, and she wound up being cursed, and she was an evil necromancer, and it's a long story. Yeah, that dude super looked like bait. Like, there was no way. Okay. Cool. Other thing we're looking for in here is rolls of paper. Didn't find. Rolls of paper are going to help us make some water skins later, which is going to make it easier to survive in the wilderness. None of this stuff is in vanilla Skyrim either, like regular unmodded Skyrim. Like, you just sort of run around and kill people and hang out, and it's still really fun, but like the survival aspect, I blame Minecraft. I really enjoy it. Alright, how are we doing on money? $696. What's that? We're gonna hire a mercenary? Sweet. We don't have enough to buy a horse. We can hire a mercenary. Drifton and White Run, because we made a complete wrong turn. But we're gonna get there. As I predicted, it's been like 45 minutes. Yeah, the rift is full of like tiny farms.
Ooh, traveler. Are you by any chance in need of a companion?
I want a companion, all right. A lifelong one. I'm not just going to ask her to marry me. I would be honored to have you. She's going to offer me this dog.
Me? No, you dunce. I was not referring to myself. I was referring to the dog.
No, that dog is a good boy and you are a bad egg for despising it.
Things are quite obvious. Which makes you well-suited to be this dog's new owner. Let that
Does the dog have a name?
How should... As a result, I have simply resorted to calling it Dog.
Something Nord like dog fear.
You sound like a dog.
Yes.
She suggested we name it Bark Red.
Bark Rensaya.
Similarly childish. The least Avruza offered a male name. She suggested we name the Avruza must have despised this alchemist a great deal to leave his legacy in the mouth of this slobbering beast.
Wow.
The dog does serve as I cannot begin to fathom how many mortal
what?
Enemies this
You're
outside of
why
that.
Why are you being such a jerk?
The dog, unfortunately, he refuses to urinate on anyone but his master.
Oh my god.
A title that I would give my left ear.
I myself would let you know, pass. From.
No, no.
Put the ear and the toes in my coin purse tonight. The dog will be gone by dawn.
There is the crux of the matter. I hesitate to even grant it that much.
You're just being really mean.
Yes, it fails to grasp the fact that
I just hate this dog so much. Please take it.
I suppose Tamriel would be a better place if we could all be the type of mortals the dogs think we are.
What's up, Wolf? Oh no! Oh no! Oh, mistakes were made. Okay, so we're gonna sheath weapons. And we're gonna talk to this guard. We're gonna be like, what's up? No, no, stop! Stop trying to kill the guard.
Stop right there.
I submit.
I guess you're...
Wow, he didn't even try and find me. So, it turns out the problem with big giant sword is that if you swing it sideways, it hits people next to you. That was unfortunate. Mistakes were made. We're not going to try and escape from the bed. We're just going to the jail. We're just going to serve our time. Janet did not want to kill that person. One of the few people in the world that Janet did not want to kill. Even though they were a giant jerk to their dog. We're not murder hobos. You know, I know murder hobos would have killed everybody there. We are, however, serving a term in jail. Here we are, in Riften. Sunny, beautiful Riften. Where we definitely didn't accidentally kill anybody. Greetings, Riften guards. No, greetings, Stormcloak soldiers. I've never seen soldiers in Riften before. Ooh.
Come to see Balaman.
Doesn't surprise me though.
With steel. Take a look.
They are. They are big fans of Stormcloaks in Riften. So we're gonna make $100 or so off of that. Sell these longbows because they're basically worthless. Janet's not a big plan person, I don't think. She's more of a doer. Now, we're gonna keep all the rest of this because we're gonna use it for crafting.
If you need any more smithing work, come see me again.
Carrying too much. What? Oh, because we are starving and dehydrated, which means our carry weight is reduced. And we are currently wielding a 26-pound sword. So, Dingle, take all this stuff. We'll keep this backpack. Put on the backpack. So now we've got this backpack. And we'll go into the Bee and Barb and see if we can't, fix up.
If you've got the coin, you've come to the right place. Pull up the seat.
Our condition.
People of Riften, heed my words.
My skill in hire Mercurio. Why hire a common with a master of magic at your side? You'll have nothing to fear.
Mercurio is a cool, handsome mage. Let's check him out. First thing we're gonna do is make it important. And let's check stats. So Mercurio doesn't wear any armor. He has 10% magic resistance from something. Probably a perk. He's good at sneaking. But mostly what he's good at is destruction and restoration.
If you've got the coin, you're welcome.
So we're going to rent a room.
Sure thing. It's yours for a day.
And we're going to get some water. I need to make him essential so nobody accidentally kills him. All my followers are essential. They can get put out of the fight, but they can get put out of the game.
No, Marumo. We talked
what do you
about
need?
This. Talon?
Yes?
Kira, certainly we can come to some sort of an understanding.
Alright, so one of these rooms is mine. Which one is it? I don't remember.
Enough. We've all heard of the dragons at every turn.
No need hey, here we are. So let's sleep for about, say, 10 hours. And then we'll eat some food.
Excuse me.
Some baked potatoes. Seared slaughter fish. Venison chop. Yeah, like we're starving. Still hungry. Full. So yeah, we really need to invest more into our like survival.
Well, customer, I'll remove myself from this den of iniquity. We're not kicking you out. Just keep the sermons at the temple and let us all sin in peace.
There we are.
I'm really getting tired of your excuses. When you borrowed the money, you said you.
So we've now traveled all the way from Markarth to Riften and walked across the entire map. Now we're going to fast travel back to Whiterun. Again, we're not going to walk literally everywhere. We're just going to walk everywhere the first time. When we get a horse, maybe we'll do a bit of riding, but and you can see that even after the fast traveling, I'm still a little hungry, so it counts that time. Let's head into White Rock and pick up a bounty. So I have a bounties mod on. I think it's Better Bounties. And what that lets me do is essentially improve the bounty cost for.
Halt! City's closed with the dragons about. Riverwood's in danger.
Yeah,
too.
I saw a dragon over in Riverwood, and they sent me to tell you to ask for help.
City's closed with dragons about.
Never it.
Official business only.
All right, so let's go inside. I'm gonna do a couple of things tonight. It's only 8:30, so. Probably gonna close the stream a little early because I've got some video editing to do, but here we are. For the first time, Whiterun. We've been to Markarth, we've been to Riften, we've picked up followers and mercenaries, we've served time in jail. For the first time, we have come to Whiterun. Oh, Gert the Unbroken. We're gonna have words later. Gert's a good time. To figure out brawling. Bro, some of my mods make brawling a little complicated, which is why I try and avoid it at all costs. I will bribe somebody before I brawl them.
If it's work you need, how about chopping up some food for the
fires? There's no bounties available because I have to go back to Jarl first. The game's like, hey, do the main quest. This guy's hard, isn't it great? So I guess I'll do the main quest. At least for a little bit. I mean, we are Janet. We do care about dragons.
Lady,
the Chosen of Akatosh, god of Dragonslayers. Lucia, trust me when I tell you I can spare way more than that, but not right now. Whoop! Looks like our game crashed. Give me, couple of seconds to start that back up. Life in Whiterun gets a little complicated. God, I really need to. I can't wait until we rearrange the studio. A couple more weeks. And then we won't have as many blank walls. And there won't be random shelves kicking around, especially empty shelves that I had to clear the books off of. Books are in print. All right. So let's load back in. It'll have auto-saved when we came out of the bar, so we're not actually that far behind. Yeah, definitely part of playing Skyrim with lots of mods. Save a lot. Like, often. Because you're gonna have crashes.
If you're looking for the court wizard,
the flip side is somewhere. I have been using so many mods for so long that I literally don't remember what regular Skyrim is like. Again, I don't even know that I'd want to play it.
Lady, fair coin.
I just don't know, like, what would it do for me? This might be a little weird too. See if it happens. It's a live another life thing. I've done this enough time that I'm familiar with the bug. Oh no, no, we're good.
There's no telling what we have to do then. Nothing. My lord.
What's the meaning of this interruption? Jarl Balbert is not receiving visitors.
I have news from Helgen about the dragon. The guards let you in.
Come on then. The Jarl will want to speak to you personally.
You mean, I'm just a humble traveler with a giant sword and three friends who look like badasses. I have a crazy face tattoo, Super Saiyan hair, and a backpack. Hello.
So, you were at Helgen. You saw this dragon with your own eyes?
Yeah, destroyed Helgen. That's what I saw. I didn't actually see Ulfric's Stormcloak or any of that stuff, because live another life.
Now prevents us. Shall we continue to trust in the strength of our walls against the dragon?
My lord, we should send
troops to Rivia. Well, like how diverse the cast of sort of Whiterun leadership is.
The Jarl of Ulfric.
I mean, Preventus is an Imperial, I think, or a Breton.
Preparing to join Ulfric's side and attack him.
Avanici, he's definitely an Imperial. Balgriff is obviously a Nord. Irileth is a Dark Elf.
Irileth. Send a detachment.
I love his accent. His accent too. Yes, will not stand idly by while the dragon burns my hold and slaughters my people.
That would be best.
So good.
Well done. You sought me out on your own initiative. Here.
Yeah, thank you. Barbarian armor.
Yes, another
I might
thing
wear that.
You could do for me. Come, let's go find Farangar. My court
so
wizard.
Go to Bleak Falls Barrow.
He's been looking into a matter related to these dragons and
Alright. Look at you, my three best friends in the whole world right now.
Father promised me a new dress days ago. Now where is it?
It takes a while to make a dress, Dagny. You have to
Farangar.
Be patient.
I think I found someone who can help.
Come to drag.
Yeah.
Well, when I say
straight to where am I going? Let's go to Bleak Falls Barrow. Conveniently, we already have a quest that will send us there.
No doubt interred in the main chamber, and bring it to me. Simplicity
is a priority. Now.
You know, if you've got the aptitude,
there are also Fendrick's guards here, and a Fendrick's ambassador. These guys are from a different magic mod, and they sell a bunch of sort of cool spells. Actually, how much money do we have? $300. You have enough for probably one cool spell.
Oh, I thought you were already on. Take a look.
Okay. So we're gonna get loot magnet.
Remember, you.
And what that's gonna do is what we're gonna do is put it on our last hotkey with our harvest spell. So what loot magnet does, loot magnet is from Apocalypse Magic. I have a lot of magic mods. I like new spells. I think I have four or five. Loot Magnet, all it does is everybody around you in a specific radius, it just loots it automatically. It takes everything off that body and puts it in your inventory. Which, when you've just killed, like, five people or a bunch
of monsters, you say, don't you worry.
It's just... Say, it's so convenient. Let's not take the sword out in town. Let's see if we can pick up a bounty first. Hold up. And then we'll... Oh, this guy is so annoying. All he does is preach about how cool Talos is. And I get it. He's a cool guy. Stop yelling at people. Please. It's not even that I don't like your god. I just don't like you, like, as a person. Alright, so let's see if we can get
come on in. If it's work you need, how about chopping up some wood for the fires? Anything else? Just let me know.
Warmed up. Loot Magnet is the backbreaker spell. Like, you wind up with tons of stuff in your inventory. But the result is that, like, it just saves so much just micromanagement and time. And you get to, like, sort it all out later. Like, the sorting is still there, but you only have to do it once instead of twice. And especially with companions, so they can carry some of the weight for me, I don't have to worry as much about... Welcome home, Fandel. Let's go see your super crush. We are going to do a favor for her, don't worry. Because I know Fandel's a super talkative guy. He's just like, come on, come on, come on, come on. He's got all this super cool armor now.
How about you make some armor? Sure you have the right raw material.
Yeah, because this is the, like, tutorial level.
Costume? You're not serious. Sure I am.
Barbarian armor. What do we think? That's a little much, but at the same time, sure, we'll rock it for a while. Very body positive. I mean, which I guess is not that hard to be, given that everyone in Skyrim is, like, super ripped. So, yeah, let's hop over here. We're hopping because we don't want to get wet, because if we get wet, we'll get cold. And trust me when I tell you that getting cold up here is... Oh, damn it! Is what we're about to experience. Oh, maybe we weren't in the water for that long, or maybe we weren't deep enough. We might have gotten off lucky there. What's up, wizard? Oh! Oh, your soft, unprotected wizard flesh. You even came with an ice spell. Boss bomb. So let's pop our buff back on. So we got a bit more health. And we'll head up the hill. So this is like one of the early quests that you're supposed to do, because you get the quest for the Golden Claw, which we picked up back in, I want to say episode 1, yeah?
Never should have come here.
Excuse me? Oh, I didn't catch that one. Until it was a little too late. What? Oh, that was unfortunate, sir.
You don't have a chance.
Alright. Kill that guy. Good job. Now we're starting to get into crossbows, too. Crossbows are deadly, deadly ranged weapons. They're really not dressed for the weather, and I don't even care. Janet don't need no shirt. Janet's got ancient magic, and a giant sword, and a backpack. What else does she really need? Apparently a drink. Have a drink? Perhaps we'll talk about curved swords even if I don't have one. God, they won't shut up about it. But we'll get to it. We'll get a curved sword at some point. Depends on, I guess, where our weapon choices take us. These guys look friendly. I bet that everything that happens on these steps works out fine for everyone involved. They're definitely not going to fuck with Janet. By the way, don't fuck with Janet. Oh, you did it. You done did it. Well, you're dead. You too. Giant sword working out real well, by the way. Oh, that guy effed. Boom! Mercurio with the kill shot. That is what we pay you for, sir. Well done. Now, we hit the loot magnet. And it just picks up all the stuff, and I don't have to deal with the, like, running around. Finding people's bodies is often the thing that makes it hard. And then we're just going to clear out my inventory. You'll notice that we have lots and lots and lots of things. So I can also wear a cloak, which will help me with my exposure protection. Adam Jensen would be super useful, but he didn't ask for this, and I'm not about to push Adam Jensen into something that he didn't ask for. I'm not that kind of person. Yeah, so we're very cold, which means we need to get inside. If we'd gotten wet, we'd be practically dead by now. It gets chilly up here. I mean, it doesn't help any that we're wearing, like, essentially a barbarian bikini top. If you're a dude, it's just, like, super bare-chested and... And Butch, of course. It's a barrel. What could possibly go wrong? Hello, new friends.
What was that? Time to end this little game.
Hello. Goodbye. Oh. Oh, you got an accident. Mercurio, that's my butt. You're hitting me in my butt. I have an arrow. Oh, it's gone now. Oh no, there it goes fading away. Literally through my face. Like that.
I'll bet these walls could tell some amazing stories.
Alright, so let's hang out here. And let's talk to Fandol and give him some equipment. The problem that Fandol's having right now is he's out of arrows. What did I say? Don't fuck with Janet. Yeah, she might have just castrated him with that giant sword. I wasn't really paying attention. What I will tell you is don't fuck with Janet. She'll kill you. Okay, everybody warms himself by the fire. They got a wood pile, so let's see if we can... we can get some firewood out of this so we can make some campfires later. And... unlock the chest. Lockpicking game. Beats the hell out of Pipe Dream. There we go. Now we're a little warm. We'll be okay. Don't mind us. Just wandering through an ancient Nordic ruin. I don't know who keeps all these fires lit. I am just going to assume magic. I just assume sorcery. Like, who comes down here and lights these fires and these candles? But it's a magical world. Let's drink some mead. See, alcohol also protects you from exposure for a little bit. It gives you, like, a little buff. Bad news, buddy. Just couldn't. And normally what you do is you look at the, things around the room, and you're like, oh, a snake and a whale, and there's another snake somewhere, I forget where, And you're like, oh, that's the solution to the puzzle. We just introduced this little spinning tripod puzzle. Or you're like me and you've done it, yeah, snake, whale. Or you're like me and you've done it a million times and you've basically memorized all of these puzzles. Most dangerous enemy in this entire place is right down those stairs. There are some skeevers down there, just giant rats. And they can infect me with diseases? And that is not good. I don't think he got me. But let's take a look. No, he did not get me. Because getting diseased when you're like halfway in a dungeon and you have no way to cure it can really debilitate you. Yeah, I think that we might need to move away from giant sword at some point. Like, we may need to compromise on a slightly smaller implement of death. Because we're hitting our own allies, and especially when our damage gets higher, it's really gonna suck. Let's run our buff. What's up, spider? Hey, we brought friends today.
Keep it away from me. Don't leave me for RK's sake.
All right, I'll cut you down.
You, over here. It's coming right. Loose. I can feel it.
You're good to go, buddy. Hey, but
why should I share the treasure with anyone?
Your face. Come on, you're gonna get hurt. Why are you running ahead? Into this deep, dark crypt. I'm sure that that's super safe. Alright, fine. Fight that crazy zombie thing. Jerk. Is he alive? Oh, no, there he goes. I'll take care of that one. I got it. So we've retrieved the golden claw from that guy's body. Find the secret. And also not step on that trap. That trap's embarrassing. Mercurio, you're an embarrassment. Draugr essentially have... Oh yeah, we might have picked up a smaller weapon. Ancient Nord Battle Axe. Done. Done deal. So it's a little smaller, does a little less damage, but it's not going to like knock out all our allies. So Draugr have all these Ancient Nord weapons. And they carry shields. Racking up the spell books too, which is good. We'll do a review at the end of the stream to see which characters we unlocked and if we unlocked any, and we'll mark them. Okay. Go! Hit the chain so that only one of them got like murdered by that. Now I have a cool battle axe. What's up? Hello, friend. Ooh, I spared your head that. You should thank me. You should definitely thank me. Alright. Ooh. Oh, Oh, right. We need to grab our... Oh, we have a greatsword, too. Ah, great axe does more damage. Yeah, it's all about the damage. Leveling that alteration. You'll notice, yeah, it's not increasing my level at all. It's just giving me more skill. What's up, bro? Boom! Take that. Taking this chest. This is like, I like this because it's a tutorial, but it's really well designed. It teaches you a whole bunch of stuff you need to know about Skyrim. There's gonna be puzzles with spinning things where the answers are right around. Savage people. You're gonna have to cut through spider webs, which we did to get to the spider and to cut Arvel down. There's gonna be herbs and things like that. We can take this path downward. We're not gonna. What's up, Draugr? Just gonna hop down here. Boom! We're not going down there because there ain't nothing really down there except a fucking good chest. But yeah, there's gonna be multiple paths and sort of little branchy bits, but not so many that it's awful. I guess opposed to Morrowind, where it was just dead ends all over the place. And monsters are going to get progressively harder when you get in. This guy's a rest. Walking. Time. Boom. Revenant ring, eh? So, in addition to putting spells in the game that can gain levels, Forgotten Magic also introduces a set of rings. And these are rings that interact with various kinds of spells, like archetypal spells. I think every archetype has two. The Revenant Ring is for warlocks. So Blight Curse is a standard like warlock spell. So in addition to giving you a boost to your health and magic, which is why we're going to equip it, victims of your Blight Curse spell will come back as zombies. Which is pretty cool. We don't have Blight Curse yet, though. But still. 25 health and magic ain't nothing to cry about. So now we're getting to the point where we are level 3, almost level 4. Got a couple of perks. We got some skills under our belt. We've got a decent buff. Whoop.
Got a bad feel.
Oh. Not going to start the zombie apocalypse. I actually really don't do zombie spells. Just because I find them a pain. But we're going to be in a position, once we're finished Bleak Falls Barrow, to go and deal with the dragon. Those guys. Bingo, buddy? Buddy? I was trying to keep all my inventory stuff on the same person. Just makes it easier to sort later. I'm gonna not hand those to Feindel because he's gonna need every arrow he's got when we get to that dragon. And probably a bit more. Give him the firewood though so we can have the camping gear. There we go. So we're still carrying a lot of weight, but... So you're gonna get puzzles, you're gonna get chambers like this, and you're gonna get the wheel puzzle. Now, the way you're supposed to do it is be like, oh, I found this golden claw. Oh, look at that. I can spin it around and look at it, and it tells me what the three symbols are. You can do that. Or you can be like me and just kind of thing. Because I am a super nerd. You put it in the middle. And this is the essentially the like unbreakable door for most of the game. Is here's this door, you can't get through it unless you have the claw, the appropriate claw, and you know the symbols. So even if you like random the symbols, you still need the claw. And claws are typically quest items. And it's always gonna have something like this.
Don't get too far ahead.
It's just this like.
Wow. Would you look at
yeah,
that?
Every dungeon in Skyrim, I think, has got something like this where they're like, damn. Look at this. Look at that light. Look at this water. Like, just, wow. Breathtaking vista, you'll always get one. Our first word wall. We've learned the word of power, but we can't use it yet. We're gonna kill dragons. And a dragon. Super powerful boss. This is a game with bosses. Because ideally you do this like as soon as you get the golden claw quest. And actually if you do it right away, like as soon as the merchant gives you the quest, you turn up with the dragon stone, which is what we came in here for the main quest. So the main quest will if you skip it, the main quest will get you to loop around and do this dungeon. And what will happen is you'll get here and you'll be like, hey, you'll get to the wizard rather and he'll be like, hey, bring me this rock. And you'll be like, this rock? I have this rock. I already did that quest, thanks. But you can do them in either order. And of course there's the secret passage that opens the back way out. I remember when I first did this quest and I discovered that there was a back door to the dungeon. Oh my god, I was so happy. I spent so much time in Morrowind trying to find my way out of dungeons. It was awful. The wolves of Skyrim. So here's our plan. I think I am going to wrap a bit early tonight. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to head to Riverwood. We're going to turn in the Golden Claw. Step one. We're going to head to Whiterun. And we're going to turn in the Dragonstone. We're going to fight a dragon. Our very first dragon ever. We're hopefully, fingers crossed, going to win. I mean, we're going to win eventually, but let's not... I want to try and maybe win in a way that doesn't embarrass myself.
I'll never forget this.
I'll never forget this.
Thing for me and my sister.
Now, bad news for you,
so much for
Lucan, is I actually want this. Because I have a display in my house where I can put this. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to sneak. And I'm going to steal it. So you might need to hire somebody else for that quest. Again. They can come to my house and fuck with Janet. Guess what? Don't fuck with Janet. She'll kill your ass. Alright. So we're going to Dragon's Reach. Yeah, and this is where like, that's the other thing. Morrowind didn't have fast travel. You had to be like super strategic and... Man. I love when people make games that are just like, here's a game you like, only better. You're like, here's a game you like, only we improved it in a bunch of different ways. Makes me really happy. So, now we get to drop off the stone. Got our Nord War Axe. Actually, we're going to swap that out for the... Oh, no, it's a war axe of cold, not a battle axe. Well, then we're not going to swap that out. See? The terminal. What's up, buddy?
The dragon stone of bleak... That is where your job ends and mine begins. The work of the mind. Sadly under...
Yeah, this guy's like a Breton, I think.
My associate here will be...
So your information was
Delphine.
And we... You Delphine. Went into Bleak Falls Barrow and got that?
Nice yeah, work.
Just send I'm me pretty a cool. When you deciphered it.
I mean, I'm covered in blood. Which is weird, because I've been killing zombies.
Faringar, you need to come at once.
A dragon. Inside of a dragon. Let's go up the stairs. Oh, well, they're still talking down there. What's up, what's up, crew?
Big at second-hand, but this talk of dragons? World's gone mad.
Like, everybody's so invested in defending their fort. Like, if you go out to Riverwood, you'll find soldiers out there that were sent by the Jarl. Like, it isn't just words on the screen.
No lollygagging.
That tells me you came from the Western Watchtower?
Yes, my lord.
I have a mod that not only puts new helmets in the game, but distributes those helmets across all the soldiers. Some of those helmets are stupid.
Faster than anything I've ever seen.
Stupid looking helmets are important.
Is it attacking the watchtower?
No, my lord.
I mostly deal with...
If he hires Commander Shepard to get the golden claw back, he's welcome to try. I can beat up Commander Shepard.
We'll take it from here. Head down to the barracks.
Yell Commander Shepard to death. Besides, this isn't a BioWare game. You'd never get the cross license and going.
You'd better gather some guardsmen and get down there.
I've already ordered my men.
Yeah, Aerolith is ahead of the game. You know why? Because she does the job and she's amazing.
There's no time to... I want you... You
survived. Like, you saw a dragon one time, so you know about dragons in that they're big and breathe fire. Go and willingly place yourself in the path of one, pretty please.
As a token of my... And please, accept this gift from my personal armor.
I should come along. I would very
it
much
is
like
a hide helmet.
No, I can't afford to risk holding it. I need you here working on ways to defend the city against
it. That is not exactly what I was looking for. But, win some, lose some. Okay. So we are going to fast travel out to our house. It is happily right out here. And then go and fight this dragon. Now we are hungry and thirsty, so let's see what we can do about that. Yeah, like having these penalties when you go into your we're not gonna fight a dragon while we are a little thirsty and a little drunk. Seems like our jam. So we're just gonna wait here for Aerolith, and it looks like they're coming along right now. Yep, here they come. It's pretty fortuitous. God, she walks so weirdly. Like she's being chafed.
No signs of any dragon right now.
Yeah, also this watchtower's now fucked.
I know it looks bad.
Alright, let's go figure out what's going on here. Now, especially, we have no ranged attacks, which reminds me. Feindahl. Let's go into your inventory. Grab a crossbow. Now, we're going to... Because the problem with dragons is that they fly. I'm going to give you this hunting bow of sparks. I'm going to give you every arrow that I have in my inventory. You're going to need all of them. Alright. Mercurio is our ringer for this. Because he has ranged attacks. He's got spells. So he's our guy for this. Cosmic has no ranged attacks. So we're going to give him the crossbow and 80 bolts. So he'll at least be able to do something while he is on the ground and the dragon is in the air. So basically, while the dragon is in the air, I have to rely on these Joker guards and these my three companions to help me out until it hits the ground, at which point it is game on. Get our buff up.
No, he's still here somewhere.
Still here? Good. But it chose with Akatosh. We're going to take that dragon on. Look at us. Look at how fucking badass we are. We're glowing. We have face tattoos. We're straight gonna wreck stuff. I'm trying to figure out why the quest didn't trigger.
This doesn't look good.
Alright, so now we go up to the top. Curious game.
Get undercover. The dragon is still around somewhere.
Typically, it gives me a thing that's like, oh, here we go. Find cover, make every shot count. Look at that. What's up, buddy? He's gonna cover the top of this and fire. The advantage of that buff is not only is it gonna buff our health, but it's going to improve our magicka regeneration, so we're gonna be able to heal faster. Right down the gullet! That's his name. He's gonna start strafing this in the air, probably, so we better get here. Yeah, our crew is up at the top of the tower and engaging it. They're taking them to town. Here are those lightning bolts. That's Mercurio. Oh, it's Irulith, actually. Alright. You two underwrite you there, Irulith. We're out of stamina. But here we go. You can get the kill shot. Yeah. I always outrun Irulith. Now we get Super Dragon Ball powered up. Yeah. I was expecting that to take longer. We've eaten a dragon soul. And now I can equip a shout.
All I hold sick. That's a shout. Like the graveyards on the mountain.
And what I can do is gather ingredients from the dragon. So I can draw his blood.
I can't believe it. You are.
I don't steal dragon souls. I eat them.
In the very. That's what you did, isn't it?
Oh yeah, you are right, sir. You are right.
That could only mean what.
I search this dragon. See what he's got. A lot of good forgotten magic spells, like right off the bat. I'm not going to be able to use any of them for a while. We got some fire spells, though, which means we might be in the money on our fortress. Okay. never heard of Tiber Septim killing any dragons. Isn't that like Tiber Septim's whole jam? Alright, let's go back to town, and then we'll close out the stream in the spreadsheet. Yeah, that was a pretty successful first dragon kill. I took a bit more precautions than I would have. Like, normally I don't go and pick up Mercurio. Because he costs money, and that's early game money that I can use for something else. But he's a really effective combat mage. Also, usually I have ranged attacks, so I can, like, shoot bows at it or whatever. But without those advantages, I don't know that I would have made it through that. Like, he was just toasting my health, and I don't have any advanced healing spells. All right. So let's just step into town and get the call, and then we'll save. Fabulous. So let's review some of our stuff here. We're all the way on the main quest here already. We've got the companions opener. Oh, we have a bounty, that's why. We have the Rhetoran's Retreat bounty. That's why we couldn't find one. And we have the Legion. Let's take a look at some of our spells. We did make the restriction that it has to be a spell that we can cast. So we can't just be like, oh, I bought a 50th level lightning spell and I can. So we have currently 125 magicka. So we can cast lightning spells, we can cast fire spells, we can't cast any ice spells yet. And we can't cast any warlock spells. We do have bound sword, but we don't have any conjuration spells that we can cast. You don't literally own no illusion spells. We have a bunch of different buffs, some of which we can't cast. Earthbound Weapon is the only one we're really cooking on here. So let's save, and then we'll come over to the spreadsheet and we'll make some notes. So let me just cycle through here, because we're going to alt-tab out of our Skyrim game. Drag our spreadsheet over. Do a little couple adjustments here, and that's definitely a big white thing. No, let me screw around with that for a second. It looks like it's still picking up my Skyrim, so I might have to quit out, which is okay because we just saved. Alright, let's try it now. Nope. Fine. Don't stream my desktop. Oh, it's like very specifically streaming a window that isn't open anymore. That's super useful. There we are. I can just pick that. There we go. Look at that. There's our spreadsheet. So, Janet. We discerned that Janet lives at the Elysium Estate. So let's take a look at some of our unlocks to see if we have unlocked that character. And what we're going to do is change the color to... go with blue if we've unlocked somebody. So we have the Companions quest, but we don't have any warlock spells that we can cast. We don't have the Thieves Guild quest yet, But we do have a rapier and a crossbow for Clive, who's our douche-faced Bravo, who's going to get mixed up in the Thieves Guild. Pavel, our two-weapon fighter, hasn't come up at all. It's rained, and we do have lightning spells. So Raiden, the Thunder God, is in. Those are different colors. Have I mentioned that I'm super colorblind? Because I am. Although it didn't rain after we had lightning spells that we could cast, so maybe we want to hold on to that. But no, we'll give them the benefit of the doubt. We have definitely killed Stormcloaks, and we have definitely killed or gotten the Legion quest. So Henry is in. Similarly, we don't have the Thieves Guild quest. We do have a bound sword, though. Nicholas, our Bard College leader, who is our wizard. He is our wizard super fan. He's got like the full like wizard gamut of tattoos. We have a summon spell, but we can't cast it yet. We don't have courage, but we can pick it up pretty easily. And we do have three companions, so we're getting pretty close. Elena, our fortress, doesn't actually require any fire spells, even though she casts fire spells, because we do have a couple. We're not Thane of Whiterun yet. Very soon, but not yet. Lucrezia, we need two Daedric quests. We currently have none. Roland, we can't unlock until we start the College of Winterhold. Roland is our guy who's going to get mixed up in rebuilding the town of Helgen. And finally, last but certainly not least, Siegfried the Knight. We need to do a bounty. And we need to have a tier 2 sword or shield. Now, we have tier 2 armor, which is the elven stuff that we were wearing for a while. And we're still wearing it on Janet. But we don't have any tier 2 swords or shields yet. So, and he's our Dragonslayer. And then we have three new characters that we're going to deal with later in a bonus stream when I have some time, which will not be this weekend. And they're going to be our support characters. So they're going to do some maybe miscellaneous quests, but a lot of it's going to be sort of more boring stuff. It's going to be smithing. It's going to be buying property. It's going to be like building infrastructure and stuff that we're not going to do on the mainstream because it's a little more slow paced, even than walking from Markarth to Riften. So we're going to do it, like on a Sunday afternoon or something for a couple hours. And we'll just sort of, that's when we'll take care of all the bookkeeping and stuff. I don't know what I just did, but it was a bad idea. There we are. So, yes, that is all the Skyrim for tonight. Shoutouts. Thanks for coming and watching. As always, it was a really good time. I'm really enjoying streaming Skyrim, and I didn't think I would. I was really super self-conscious about it. Because it's like my game and my stories and things like that. I'm gonna maybe shuffle a little closer to the center of frame. And I haven't dealt with my hair the whole night, so why bother now? But yeah, I was really sort of nervous about it. And I'm really enjoying it. So yeah, you can follow me on Twitter at Concept Crucible, which is down here. My YouTube channel, which is also where the stream replays are gonna go up. We also may do podcasts and Minecraft videos at Wutsu Riot. And they're going to be, I'm going to put the mod list and a link to the spreadsheet on jimtobwell.com, as well as hopefully a Skyrim-related blog post or two. I have to launch a new website this month, so we'll see how timing and work and all that stuff goes with that. But hopefully tomorrow morning, depending on how video editing goes, at least for the mod list. And, whoa, I'm going to be at Maker Expo on September 10th. Where we'll be doing an 8-hour podcast. We're going to be interviewing people, we're going to be interviewing makers and artists and local politicians and public figures and everybody we can, people from the crowd, to talk about sort of the cool parts of making things. So I'm really excited for that. We just finished planning it last night, and we've still got some more stuff to do, but it's going to be great. And it's going to be like nothing else that's there. So I'm intrigued. Anyway, have a good night. I gotta go and eat some food and take some meds. Yes. Kids, take your meds. All right, see everybody later.